Hey guys, this is Rithvik Chatterjee. I just graduated from school this year and will be studying computer science in university in about a month. Welcome to our channel, Learn Competitive Programming with CodeChef. If you're interested in competitive programming and want to learn and master data structures and algorithms, this is a one-stop destination for you. Every week, we'll be posting CodeChef problem explanations, conceptual videos on various programming paradigms, and also conduct live problem-solving sessions. Before we actually get started, here's a reminder to hit the subscribe button if you haven't yet already. Great. Now that you've subscribed, let's get started. This is a video editorial for the second problem from INOI 2020, 3xN tiling. The problem code for this is INOI 2002. In this problem, we're given an n times m grid where n is less than or equal to 3 and m is less than or equal to 10 to the power of 6. We're also given an infinite number of three types of tiles, 1 times 3 tiles, 2 times 2 tiles, and 3 times 1 tiles. We're meant to count the number of ways to tile the n times m grid such that there are no overlapping tiles, the entire grid gets tiled, and all tiles remain within the grid. Let's try and figure out what happens if n is equal to 1. If we try placing a 3 times 1 tile, it won't fit as it has 3 rows and our grid has just one row. Similarly, if we try placing a 2 times 2 tile, it won't fit as it has 2 rows and our grid has just one row. We can see that a 1 times 3 tile fits in the grid perfectly. It occupies 3 consecutive columns in the only row in the grid. Given that we only fill grids of this type with 1 times 3 tiles and one such tile fills up 3 consecutive columns, we can only fill up the grid in one way, if m is a multiple of 3. Otherwise, there'll always be at least one unoccupied column which we can't fill up, as the tiles can't overlap. For example, out here, m is equal to 7, which isn't a multiple of 3. So we can't fill this grid as there's one empty cell left. However, if m is equal to 6, it could be filled up completely. Now let's take a look at what happens when n is equal to 2. If we try placing a 3 times 1 tile, it won't fit in the grid as the grid has just 2 rows, while the tile has 3 rows. A square fits perfectly, leaving m minus 2 columns behind it if it's placed at the very end. If we use a 1 times 3 tile to fill the top right corner, we are forced to use a 1 times 3 tile below it as well. We can fit in 2 1 times 3 tiles as well, leaving us with m minus 3 columns behind it if it's placed at the very end. Keeping this in mind, let's try to come up with a recursive DP solution, as placing a single tile on this grid leaves a part of the grid that's left to be tiled. If we know the number of ways there are to tile the remaining part, we can know how many ways there are to tile the entire grid. Therefore, let DP of I be the number of ways to tile the grid till the ith column. If we place a 2 times 2 square, we can see that we have m minus 2 columns left to fill. Hence, dp of I depends on dp of I minus 2, as that's the number of ways to tile the remaining grid. If we place 2 1 times 3 tiles, the number of ways to tile the remaining grid is dp of I minus 3. Hence, we arrive at dp of I is equal to dp of I minus 2 plus dp of I minus 3. Now let's look at a 3 times m grid. It's a bit different this time, as there are ways to completely fill the ith column without completely filling the columns before it, while only considering the tiles being used to fill the ith column. Let's look at an example. Let's place a 2 times 2 square at the bottom. This forces us to place a 1 times 3 tile above it. We arrive at a state where the corner cell in a grid is unfilled, so we can fill it up. Hence, we need to know the number of ways to fill the rest of the grid. This ends up being the number of ways to fill the grid such that the last column's corner cell isn't filled. While calculating the number of ways to arrive at this state, if we place a 2 times 2 square at the bottom, we see that we arrive at a state where the corner and the center cell in the last column in a grid is unfilled, while only one corner is filled. Hence, we need to know the total number of ways to fill the grid such that only one of the corners are filled. Let dp of I of 1 be similar to our earlier dp definition, where it denotes the answer till the ith column if the ith column is completely filled. Let dp of I of 2 be the number of ways to fill a grid with I minus 1 full columns and the ith column having a missing corner, which means that the corner remains unfilled. let DP of I of 3 be the number of ways to fill a grid with I minus 1 full columns and the ith column having only one corner filled, with the other two cells in the column remaining unfilled. Let's figure out what DP of I of 1 is first. We can place a 3 times 1 cell which completely covers the ith column. The number of ways to make this is DP of I minus 1 of 1. If we use a 1 times 3 tile to fill the top right corner, we can use 2 1 times 3 tiles below it as well. So, we can place 3 1 times 3 cells too, which completely covers all columns from I minus 2 to I. Hence the number of ways to make this is DP of I minus 3 of 1. Alternatively, we can place a 2 times 2 square below the 1 times 3 tile. Hence, we can place a combination of a 1 times 3 tile and a 2 times 2 square tile. This combination only works if everything before the I minus second column is filled, and the I minus second column only has one empty corner cell. This is equal to DP of I minus 2 of 2. Note that the square can either be placed on the top or at the bottom, so there are two ways of placing this. Hence, we arrive at DP of I of 1 is equal to DP of I minus 1 of 1 plus DP of I minus 3 of 1 plus 2 times DP of I minus 2 of 2. Let's figure out what DP of I of 2 is. We can place a 2 times 2 tile. This completely covers two rows in the ith column and the I minus first column. While the ith column only has two rows to cover, the I minus first column has three. Hence, we are going to end up with a corner piece to fill in the I minus first row. And now everything before the I minus first row has to be filled as well. This is the same as DP of I minus 1 of 3. Alternatively, if we use two 1 times 3 tiles to fill the last column, we're forced to place another 1 times 3 tile above it. So, we can place 3 1 times 3 tiles. This fills up all available cells from the I minus second to the ith columns, but the I minus third column only has a one cell filled corner. Hence, we need to know the number of ways to tile till the I minus fourth column, along with the center and a corner cell in the I minus third column. This is equivalent to DP of I minus 3 of 2. Hence, we arrive at DP of I of 2 is equal to DP of I minus 1 of 3 plus DP of I minus 3 of 2. Let's look at DP of I of 3. The only way to fill only one cell in a column is using a 1 times 3 tile, above which we can place either two 1 times 3 tiles or a 2 times 2 square tile. So, we can fill it with a square and a 1 times 3 tile. This fills up all available cells completely, from the I minus second to the ith columns. The number of ways to tile the rest is DP of I minus 3 of 1. We could also place 3 1 times 3 tiles. This leaves the corner cell in the I minus third column plus everything before the I minus third column left to tile. This is equivalent to DP of I minus 3 of 3. Hence, we arrive at DP of I of 3 is equal to DP of I minus 3 of 1 plus DP of I minus 3 of 3. Right, so let's take a look at the code now. Here we have t test cases, so we just go through each test case individually and we clear our DP arrays every time, and as we know it's a DP problem, therefore we need to keep DP arrays. K is equal to number of rows and n is equal to the number of columns. So if we have just one row, as I mentioned before, if the number of columns is a multiple of 3, then there's only one way to tile it, using only 1 times 3 tiles. Otherwise, there's no way to tile it. Therefore, the answer is 0. Then, if the number of rows is equal to 2, we arrived at this recurrence relation, which is dp2 of I is equal to dp2 of I minus 2 plus dp2 of I minus 3. And our base cases in this case is dp2 of 2 is equal to 1, because we can use just 1 2 times 2 square. And dp2 of 3 is equal to 1, as we can use 2 1 times 3 tiles. So we go all the way up until n, and our final answer is dp2 of n. Now, going to when we have 3 rows, our recurrence relations is just what I explained in the video. But the base case out here is dp of 0 of 1 is equal to 1. And the reason behind this is dp of 0 is essentially everything before the first column. And that's when we have absolutely nothing. So the number of ways of tiling nothing is equal to just one way using no tiles. Therefore, dp of 0 of 1 is equal to 1. And then we go all the way from 1 up to n. Oops. We go all the way from 1 up to n. And basically out here, we check if I is greater than or equal to 2 to go back by minus 2. And I is greater than or equal to 3 to go back by minus 3 to make sure we don't accidentally end up accessing any negative indices. And yeah, the recurrence relations are exactly what I mentioned in the video. And every time we do a calculation, we mod it. As you meant, find that the total number of ways mod 110 to the power of 9 plus 7. And then our final answer is just dp of n of 1, as that's the number of ways of tiling it till the nth column, such that everything in the nth column is completely tiled. All the rows in the nth column are completely tiled as well. So yeah, there's not much to it if you've understood the recurrence relations. It's just implementing what I mentioned in the video.